Although she's difficult to see in her yellow helmet, this was one of the last jumps Maria Robledo Vallejo of Colombia made before falling to her death on Highway 99.
Wasn't able to make it back off of the freeway. Why she went that far downwind, nobody knows. It's a decision she made.
Skydiver Alberto Maeso of Spain had just met her and knew her 3 days.
Energía especial, you know. She have bad day.
The owner, Bill Dow, says the woman who was killed was an experienced skydiver with 155 jumps under her belt.
That included 20 jumps at the center in the past 2 weeks. But at the time of her jump, the wind speed was 15 miles per hour. That would not allow a beginner to go, but an experienced one like Robledo Vallejo could.
Once you get your A license, which is 25 jumps, then the wind discretion is up to you, your parachute, your weight. There's a lot of variables.
The Lodi Parachute Center has had a history of tragedy and trouble. Since 2000, 19 deaths. In 2010, the center was fined $664,000 for failing to perform required aircraft parts replacements and failing to comply with safety directives. In 2011, a $269,000 fine for allegedly operating a plane on flights not in compliance with federal aviation regulations. Last year, the FBI and other federal agencies raided the center, but Das says to this day, he hasn't been charged.
They drained every computer, went through all the lockers, anything that was in any of the lockers they took.
Some have asked, with all the deaths, how is the center still open? According to the FAA, quote, we need to find regulatory violations to revoke an FAA-issued certificate. The parachute center itself does not have a certificate, end quote. However, the FAA can fine business owners for poor aircraft maintenance.